Very good morning to all the students of class 10th D. Kindly switch on the videos, beta. We are going to read a new chapter today, The 100 Dresses, part 1. Actually, this chapter is in two parts. You know, you have seen many movies which have multiple parts and you keep on waiting for the other next, what happens next. Fine. And similarly, this is very interesting chapter which will be capturing your attention till end, and you will be, you know, you won't be able to stop yourself. Okay, what will happen next in the next part? Clear? So I asked you one question, but nobody of you answered. I asked that, you know, this is the classroom scene. Most of the times what happens, we make fun of others. Or others make fun of us. Sometimes we make fun of others, and sometimes it can be related to, sometimes it's up to body shaming about someone's, you can say, height, about someone's, how one's look, how the one dresses up. Fine. And this happens around us only. We people, we do. And sometimes others also do it with us. So this is the harsh reality of our society, that we do everything but we never accept. So I asked many of you that, have you ever, you can say, made fun of others, but nobody raised hand. I asked, have you been mocked at by others? Even then you never said, but this is a part of life, it happens. Maybe you are hesitating a bit, okay, it's okay, fine. So I'm coming back to this chapter, beta. As you can see, on the board, I have written characters and the name of the chapter, The 100 Dresses, Part 1. Fine, so I would be telling you the main characters. Dakshita, you can adjust your camera, beta. I'm not able to see your face. Dakshita, okay? Yes, this is perfect. So, mainly we have, today we would be reading about three characters, okay? Wanda Petronsky, Peggy and Maddie. So kindly note down, okay? Because these are the names sometimes we even forget. The names are different kinds. It's difficult for us to remember. So whenever I start teaching you, firstly, you note down the names of the characters. So they are the pivotal characters. There are many other characters also, but they are the main characters around which the whole story is going to revolve, okay? So Wanda Petronsky, I have written this name with blue color, why? And I have written in the bracket, you can see protagonist. Because she's the protagonist. And Peggy, she is the most popular girl of the school. Clear? Peggy is the most popular girl of the school. You know, sometimes... And why she is the most popular? Because she comes from a rich background. She's pretty also. And she has curly hair. And the way she talks, fine. So that has made her quite popular. And she's very self-obsessed about herself, that yes, I'm pretty and I have many friends and I come from such background. And then we have another character, Maddie. Maddie is Peggy's, you can say, best friend, or all the time she could be seen hanging out with Peggy only. Clear? So Maddie is Peggy's friend. All the characters are clear to all of you. But now let me tell you the brief background of these three characters. They all come from different backgrounds. Fine? Wanda Petronsky hails from a very poor family. The place where she lives, that is quite muddy. And when she, you know, comes to school, her boots usually fill with filth only, and dust is there, dirt is there, and everybody made fun of this thing, that see Wanda's shoes. And every day, Wanda Petronsky wears the same dress, a blue colored dress, on same day. There is no particular uniform code the way you people are having. Clear? So students can come wearing their own clothes. So Wanda wears same dress on every day. And Peggy obviously she's from rich background, wearing different dresses, and you know, always making fun of Vanda for wearing same dress. And then we have Maddie. Maddie is also from poor background, but Maddie is not as poor as Vanda Petronsky is. This is the difference. They have not used middle class family. They have just said Maddie is also poor, but not as poor as Vanda is. Clear? So this is the brief introduction of these three characters. Okay? If any doubt, you can ask me. I would be showing you a video also after giving, you can say, brief. So, as you can see the screen in front of you, Vita, The 100 Dresses Part 1 by Eleanor Elks. Before you read, I would be reading these three points first. Okay. How do we judge the people around us by their money, wealth, and possessions? This is the human psychology. Actually, when we, you know, see people around us, our mind, you know, mindset is like that only, maybe, that we start judging the people on the basis of how, firstly, looks, how the person looks. If the person doesn't look nice, it doesn't mean that person is not nice. Fine. If a person is not looking nice, that is not his or her fault. This is the way the biologically he looks. One has to accept it. So we people start judging people by their money, their looks, the wealth and possessions mainly, that how rich he or she is. A person having car is considered rich in our society, wearing branded clothes and, you know, swanking about such possessions. And the people, and you know, bad thing is, I feel bad when even students or people coming from humble background, they are also hiding it. One should not be ashamed of where do you come from. Fine, whether it's a humble background, whether you are, this is not your fault. Accept it. We all are equals. Fine. So rather than judging a person by seeing a house or clothes or vehicle he or she is coming on, this is really bad on part of all of us. So this story is a sensitive account. You know, after reading, you will realize that clothing has nothing to do with what we are. All that matters is who you are, what sort of a personality you are, how you carry yourself, how confident you are about your achievements. You know, one should be comfortable in one's own skin. We are ashamed of our parents. On parents' meet, I have seen many students. They don't let their parents speak only. Why? Because they think that if our parents will speak, it will be insult to us. Why? They have raised you like anything. They have given their whole life to raise you people, and we are ashamed of them. Very bad it is. So this is story is very close to my heart. Why? Because this is very sensitive account, that how a poor young girl is judged by her classmates. Vanda Petronsky is a young Polish girl who goes to school with other American children in an American town. These other children see Vanda as different in many ways. Can you guess how they treat her? Read the information in the box below. Find out more about this community or about a related topic from an encyclopedia or the internet. So this is your homework. I'm not going to tell you about this much. You will be telling me about this. The Polish American community in the United States. You know, in every country, in every state, there are communities which are treated beneath the other communities. Just on the basis of caste, creed, background, they are treated badly. So being Polish American community, she hails from Polish American community. Okay. So that's why she was being treated badly. And moreover, she was not having dresses, different dresses to wear on daily basis. She was not having different shoes. Always mud could be seen on her shoes and people would make fun of her. Clear? So this box you would be reading on your own. Okay, this is your homework. I would be giving the gist of it tomorrow, and I would be asking you first. So now let's jump up to our story. On page number 64, I introduced all the characters. Firstly, who will tell me the three characters and the background? I will unmute you. You can speak. The three characters and their background. I have given you the introduction. Yes. Visam, you're the first one to raise hand, so speak.
The first character of this story is Suvendra, and she is a poor girl and her background is not so good, like she wears old clothes. And
next
the
one,
the second next. Is, and the next one is Peggy's, and her, she is a popular girl of the school because she's rich and she wears fashionable clothes. And next one is Mary, that is Peggy's friend.
Yes, very good. So you can mute yourself. Okay. Now, we would be continuing. Today, Monday, Wanda Petronsky was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline. So, underline, the full name of Maddie is Madeline. Actually, we people call, you know, we start using nicknames for your friends sometimes. In that way, Madeline is her full name, Peggy and Madeline, and nickname is Maddie. So, don't get confused, okay? So today is Monday and Wanda Petronsky was not in her seat. Not even Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. And when she was absent, nobody noticed it even that she was not in the class. Why she was absent? This is the question. Not even Madeline and Peggy. Peggy and Maddie, both of them, even the girls who used to make fun of this Wanda Petronsky, even both the girls even did not notice. Usually, Wanda sat in the seat, underline, this is a question in your textbook, beta, you will be getting it. Where would she sit? Usually, Wanda Petronsky sat in the seat next to the last seat in the last row in room number 13. So room number is 13. She would sit in the last seat of the last desk. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat. You know, usually the students who are very good at studies and they want to concentrate what teacher is teaching, they keep on sitting on the first desk, and the ones who don't want to listen to the teacher or those who do not get good marks, I'm not bifurcating that those who sit at last desk, they are not good students, but mainly it happens. The ones who want to talk, they usually prefer to sit at the last. Fine. So where all the rough boys who were not getting good marks, they were sitting in the corners, and there was most scuffling of feet. Scuffling of feet, you can hear dragging movements of the feet on the ground. That shows that you are not able to sit. Are you those, the ones who do not have patience to listen to the teacher, those who after every minute talk and chit chat with their friends, fine, such kind of students. So most roars of laughter when anything funny was said, and most mud and dirt on the floor. You got my point, that the students who were coming from such areas, having mud and dirt, feeling from poor background, and also not only poor background, but mainly they were very casual students who were not into studies much, who were into just laughing and making fun of others, those who used to sit at last. But why Wanda was sitting? She was not a rough child, but she was being segregated by the rest of the students. Other students were not accepting her because of her background, being an American Polish girl. Wanda did not sit there, underline this also again, the next question, because she was rough and noisy. On the contrary, she was very quiet. And rarely she spoke or rarely she said anything at all. Why she had become introvert? There is a reason. Because there is no one who's talking to her. And nobody had ever heard her laugh out loud. Nobody has even seen this little girl laughing out loudly. You know, confidence comes when you are getting boosted up from your friends, from your family, from teacher. this girl, she's already struggling to get proper basic facilities in life. And when she comes to school in such circumstances, she's being made fun of. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crooked sort of smile, but that was all. Nobody has seen her laughing. Sometimes she smiled, but even that was a crooked smile, means a half-hearted smile. She was not happy from within, maybe. And maybe she was so made conscious by commenting by others only. Fine. Nobody knew exactly why Vanda sat in the seat, unless it was because she came all the way from underline. She came from Boggins Heights. This is the area where she lives. She comes from Boggins Heights, and her feet were usually caked with dry mud. Caked with dry mud means filled with mud. Kichad laga hota tha. But no one really thought much about Vanda Petronsky once she sat in the corner of the room. And when she entered, after making fun of her shoes and mud and same dress, she would go at last and nobody even look at her. The time when they thought about Vanda was outside of school hours at noon time, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early underline. When would they look at Vanda? This is the time. When would they make fun of Vanda? Not in the classroom, but when Vanda was outside the school, when break is there, when noon time, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before school began, when they were coming to school, when they were leaving the school, when in the recess, when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard. So this was the time she was being mocked at by others. Then sometimes they waited for Vanda to have fun with her. See, the heights. Sometimes they were thinking that, okay, we don't have anything else to do. Let's make fun of Vanda today. So they would wait for her, that when she would pass with muddy boots, we would make fun of her. The next Tuesday, Vanda was not in school either. You remember on Monday, she was not there, but nobody noticed. On Tuesday, Vanda was not in school either. On Tuesday also, she did not come to school. She was quite a regular child otherwise. And nobody noticed her absence again. Nobody noticed. But on Wednesday, underline, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children who got good marks and who did not track in a whole lot of mud, did notice that Vanda was not there. So now these two girls, Peggy and Maddie, those friends, they noticed on Wednesday that where is this girl? And how they noticed? Because Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. Now, underline a brief character sketch of Peggy they are given. She was pretty. She had many pretty clothes and her hair was curly. Maddie was her closest friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Vanda's absence, underline this, this is the reason, beta. Because Vanda had made them late to school. How Vanda made them late to school? They had waited and waited for Vanda to have some fun with her. And she just had not come. They often waited for Vanda Petronsky to have fun with her. So they were waiting on the way when they were coming to school that Vanda would be coming and we would make fun of her. But that day, Vanda did not come. They kept on waiting. And then they realized, okay, this girl is not there. Now, these four questions you would be answering, beta. First question is, where in the classroom does Vanda sit and why? Where in the classroom Yes, Farina.
Vanda sat in the last seat of the last row in room number 13 because her feet were caked with mud as she walked from Boggins Heights.
Yes, fine. Right answer. Second question is, where does Vanda live? What kind of a place do you think it is? I already made you. Yes, Divyansh, you can speak better.
Ma'am, Vanda lives at Boggins Heights. It is a place where poor people are supposed to live. There is mud and dirt at this place, at that place. It is away from the city.
Yes, you can see. Right answer. You can mute yourself better. Third question is, when and why do Peggy and Maddie notice Wanda's absence? Otherwise, on Monday and Tuesday, nobody noticed. On Wednesday, same students want answer, beta. Any other child? Yes, Dakshita, you can answer.
Peggy and Maddie noticed Wanda's absence because Wanda had made them late to school. They waited on the day of school because they wanted to make fun of Wanda, but she didn't came.
Yes. Anything else?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Dakshita, thank you to all the participants who are actively participating in giving answers. What do you think to have fun with her means? Last question of this page. What do you think it means to have fun with her? Yes, Bissam, to tease her. Right answer. To mock at her and the place where she lives. To tease her and to laugh out of it after making fun of her. Clear? To have fun with her means. So you, no, it doesn't mean enjoy with someone, Divyansh, literal meaning, but in this context, it means to make fun of others, to make mock at others. So we, why will they wait for her if they want to do so? Beta, Princy is asking why they would wait. They would wait because in class, there is no situation that they would make fun because they would sit in the front desk. Maddie, see the way I'm just pronouncing the name. Sometimes it happens. Maddie and Peggy, both of them, they were sitting at the front desks most of the times with because they used to get good marks and she would sit at the last desk. So they would not get chance in the class. Moreover, teacher would be there. So already they have discussed the time when they would make fun of her. Whenever there is break, or when she was coming to school or when they were leaving from school. So this was the time they would make fun of Wanda Petronsky. That's why they would wait on the way. Let's wait. Wanda would be coming and we will make fun and have fun together and mock at her. Everything is clear. So send me thumbs up if chapter read so far is clear to all the students. Most of you are saying yes. Any doubts, you can ask me now. I'll be showing you the video tomorrow because we're not left with much time.